I'm sorry, I want to have a date.
Welcome back to Deck 13 Inside. My name is Phil and today I'm joined by my big brother Felix, 12-year veteran of Deck 13, head of QA and IT wizard. Quick questions for starters. What was the first game you played and what is your favorite game?
My first game really was Pong at a children's birthday. And my favorite game really depends on the time when I played. It started with Commodore 64. Bruce Lee was one of my favorites.
Then I got an Atari ST. Dungeon Master was my favorite there. And then I went into PC gaming. And Half-Life blew me away. The Baldur's Gate Saga, all-time favorites. KOTOR, Knights of the Republic. Counter-Strike 0.7 to 1.6 for all of you who know this shit. Let's stop laughing. Natural Selection, a mod for Half-Life. And then I played Battlefield 2. World of Warcraft got me in its fangs, and currently The Witcher 3 and Borderlands 3 are the games that I currently like the most.
But it really depends on when you... If you ask a 20-year-old Felix, he would say this. 30-year-old Felix would say this, and I'm still older than 30.
QA is short for quality assurance. What are the tasks of your team? What are the processes?
Basically, we have four main tasks that we deal with. It's testing, documentation, coordination, and support. Let me start with testing. We are getting new builds every day for each platform. Our testers start testing the game and report every bug that they encounter. They write the issue in the database with steps to reproduce, videos, screenshots, and then they assign it to the person in the team who is responsible for this area of the game. Once the bug is fixed, it gets resolved and we then do test it again and see that it doesn't occur anymore. The next part is documentation. Every aspect on the game has to be documented so that we know and that external testers know what to expect, how the games work and what's in it. The whole dev team is writing down what they have integrated in the build, and then QA looks at the existing documentation and often has to add specific information that are QA relevant. This also leads directly to coordination. We are working together with external testing partners. Most important is Focus QA. They have a large QA. Reynolds QA is rather small. We prepare the builds for external QA. We have to make sure that they know what to test, what to look out for, how the game is supposed to work, create test tasks, and then look at the finished test tasks to see, okay, this worked, this does not work, and also to have a track record of what was tested in which build. And the fourth point is support. That's not always a QA task. In Deck 13, we do it this way. Every support request that comes via our website lands at QA. We look at them and we try to answer as many and as good as possible. We try to help the players, sometimes fixing save games, which can only be done on PC, and giving them hints on what to do or how to fix the bug, if there's a workaround, if not. Sometimes we learn about bugs throughout the port website, and that's always a little bit chagrin for us, because why didn't we find that? So really, people are helping us making a better game, and well, thanks for that.
One thing the people out there keep asking about, and let me add, rightfully so, the patch on consoles that we are currently working on. How are you involved in that?
I'm involved pretty closely in that process. And we are not happy that it took so long to create the patch. So first of all, we have to identify the issues that should be addressed in the patch. Time is always limited. The time we have to create the fixes and put them into the build and verify that they work. So we need to prioritize what should go into the build and what has to be fixed first. Once we have a list, it goes to the dev team and they are working very hard to get the issues fixed. Then it goes back to QA that we verify, okay, the issues have been addressed. We have a checklist of issues that must be in the build. And then I have to make sure that we have to deliver the builds on time to our external partner, Focus. Focus QA is always the first to have a look at the build. Once they verify the fixes are in, the builds get delivered to another instance. And this time it's submission at Microsoft and Sony to make sure that the builds comply to their standards. And this takes additional time for testing. So we always, once we are done, there's always some time behind this that has to be planned until the game is ready for release.
Since you just mentioned the submission process for consoles, can you share some more information about that? How does it work and how does it differentiate from releasing a patch on PC?
I can answer the last question first. Releasing a patch on PC is pretty easy, especially on Steam. You just go into your into the builds depot and say publish to default, and that's it. It's one button click. On consoles, it's different. Sony and Microsoft wants the game to adhere to their standards. That means they have a large catalog of compliance that has to be that the game has to fulfill. After it went through Focus QA, it goes to the QAs at Microsoft and Sony, and this process takes up to 5 workdays that they verify the build is technically sound and all the other standards they have. For example, the wording has to be correct. In Canadian French, a controller on PS4 is called, can be called manette. In French, it has to be called manette de fille. So if you have the wrong translation from, for example, for the Canadian French in the French build, you get a fail. So sometimes you really have to have specialists that know exactly what to look out for and what the console standards are to make sure you pass these submissions.
Can you tell us what the console patch will include?
Yes, first of all, we have improved the texture streaming process. Textures look crisper and better. Second, we have performance optimizations. We added a lot of them that the game runs better and at stable frame rates. Third, we have stability improvements because that the game runs more smoothly. Then we have quest fixes, balancing fixes, and multiple issues that popped up that we have fixed that can be put into one big category.
So we now know why console patches take out longer to push out. Can you share the current status of our patch?
Of course, Philip Eyenglenn. No, Phil Eyenglenn, I can do that for you. No, let's get serious again. We put as much content, as many fixes as possible into the patches, and they went to Microsoft and Sony, and it took a little longer, and now we have to wait for a new slot because it's October already, and the big boys are pushing their builds to submission for the Christmas season, so the Call of Duties and whatnot, they are using up the resources from Microsoft and Sony. So we have to wait a bit, and we are very optimistic that we can have the builds out very, very soon, but I have no exact date yet, I'm sorry, I want to have a date. We want to have the patch out of the door and live as much as you guys do, and we want to do it as fast as possible, and we're working very hard on it.
And that's it for this week of Deck 13 Inside. I hope the information we brought to you gives you a little bit more perspective on how things work on the technical side. I know waiting sucks, and we are sorry for the delayed patch. We appreciate your patience, and we appreciate every one of you who's enjoying Jericho City. If you want to watch the latest episodes of Deck 13 Inside, you can click right here or here for the playlist. Thanks for tuning in. Until next week. Bye-bye.